the other side of our studio with Media Watch, Emma James, starting out with the reaction to this devastating fire at Brazil's National Museum.
Yes, it marked its bicentennial anniversary on June the 6th this year. And now, really, the nation is in mourning. Many people sharing images like this one with the word luto, that hashtag being used very widely as well, meaning simply mourning, because it is such an important part of Brazil's cultural heritage and many other countries too, because it wasn't just Brazilian artefacts that it held. This is one of the things that has been lost. It's a fresco, a Roman fresco from Pompeii that survived the fiery wrath of Vesuvius, but then was destroyed in this fire, which many people are saying is the result of neglect and could and should have been avoided. This gentleman says, survived a volcano but couldn't handle the Brazilian politics. Sad day. More about the politics of this in a moment. One of the other things that is a great tragedy to note is that part of the reason this fire was able to take such hold is there was a delay in getting water to it because two of the fire hydrants weren't working. They had run dry, firefighters having to wait for water trucks to arrive, having collected water from nearby lakes. This historian really putting into context the scale of what has been lost in this fire. Quai Branly, a museum here in Paris, has an estimated 450,000 objects. The British Museum, 8 million works. But the National Museum in Brazil has an estimated, or had an estimated, 20 million objects. It really is heartbreaking to see such a loss on such a scale. And really, it all happened very, very quickly. Now, what we are starting to see is the anger. Actually, people taking to the streets, standing in front of the museum, staging these protests, saying this was a tragedy that was foretold. And it was. Many people sharing this article, which warned about the cuts to maintenance funding that have been going on for many, many years, meaning that in the first 4 months of 2018, they'd only received 11,000 euros to help maintain what was such an immensely important historical site. Now, that was published 3 months ago. And in it, the director said that he had all these plans to invest. He wanted to model it on New York's Natural History Museum. But already 10 of its 30 exhibition halls were closed. And visitor numbers had actually plummeted because many people thought this museum was already shut down. It is unlikely that it will be resurrected in anything like its former glory. This is how it looks now, these images from TV Globo. There are a couple of things that have survived, including a meteor from the 18th century, which weighs more than 5 tons. That's one of the few things still standing in the rubble. And this image really sums up the day, I think, a firefighter looking pretty forlorn, carrying in his hand one of the artefacts that did manage to survive.
So, national tragedy, international perspective to it as well, and unsurprisingly, it is becoming more and more politicised.
Very much so. The current president, Michel Temer, spoke of the incalculable loss. But it's Dilma Rousseff, the former president, who has really courted controversy and made a lot of people very angry. She tweeted this. She accused what she called the cut-cut scammers of freezing investment for 20 years in health, education and culture, compromising the future until the past is turned into ashes. Now, that's all very poetic, but a lot of people feeling that really she should have been shouldering more of the blame on this one. This person and saying lying opportunist and has some accompanying headlines detailing budget cuts that happened under her administration. This gentleman too saying, with all due respect, former president, are you not to blame as well? But as you say, it is an international tragedy and many people voicing their support and their sadness, including the British Library, who says this is a reminder of the fragility and preciousness of our shared global heritage.
And those things, of course, lost forever, which is incredibly tragic on that level. Now, here in France, there's a new initiative to protect crumbling heritage sites. But not everyone is impressed by this project. Do explain.
Yes, it's called the Loto du Patrimoine, which basically means heritage lottery. If you're from the UK, it'll sound familiar. That's kind of where they got their inspiration. And the idea is it's a lottery to raise all sorts of money, millions of euros, to fund work on key sites across the country, 270 in all. But there are 18 in particular that are described as emblematic endangered monuments, including this one, a Roman aqueduct near Lyon. There are also old chateaux, churches, a railway roundhouse, and this Fort Sigogne in Finistère, which is a military fort currently used by members of a local sailing club. I'm not sure whether they will still be allowed to use it once money's been...
A great place for your sailing club, you know.
Yes, I don't know whether they'll still be able to use it once money's been poured into to do it up. But anyway, they are hoping that this lotto is going to raise between 15 and 20 million euros for this cause. There's going to be a draw on the 14th of September for a super lotto jackpot of 13 million, which ties in with when we have the Heritage Weekend here in France. There are also 12 million scratch cards on sale, six of which have a jackpot of 1.5 million on them. They are expensive, though, 15 euros a pop for those scratch cards. Some people taking part saying, this is my contribution to our heritage. Others, though, are very angry about the amount of money that is going into the projects themselves. The tickets cost 15 euros. Only 1 euro 50 actually goes to the Heritage Foundation, which does seem a very, very small figure. Some people calling it a beautiful con. This person saying, I was interested in the idea to begin with, then I read about it, and we are being taken for idiots.
That just about sums it all up. Emma, thanks to you very much indeed for your Meteor Watch. Emma James.